Good morning. My name is Jim McKenna, town manager of this wonderful community of Winthrop, and welcome everybody. It's I usually open these events saying it's a wonderful day in Winthrop, and it is, despite the weather. It's always wonderful to have all of you here, especially our speaker, who we love dearly, and our lieutenant governor, and our senator, and so many state representatives, Secretary Beaton, our council president, and members of our community are here. I even dragged my sons along for a day of showcasing this great community. And so many of you from other communities, welcome to Winthrop. You're in a building here that will soon be occupied by folks who will be taking a ferry, a commuter ferry from Winthrop to Boston. It's a 17-minute ride from here to Boston, and we're very excited. The boat will be here in a couple of weeks. We hope you all come back and enjoy this ferry service and quick access. It's probably, you know, I read that in 1630, public transportation began in Massachusetts. It also was the first public transportation in America, and it was a ferry service between Charlestown and Boston. So it's full circle, if you will, coming back to the cleanest form of transportation that we know of, which is ferry service. So we're excited that you're here in this building, and we're excited to have all of you here with a very impressive agenda this morning. But before we start that, I want to make a quick presentation to Lieutenant Governor Polito. This is a box of cookies from Adriana's. Now, those of you who are locals know what I'm giving her, which is probably the best stuff that we've got. But this is the cookies that the governor loves. And he drives from Swampscott through Winthrop to grab a box of these for special occasions. And I thought it was only fitting that you also became a fan of Adriana's and could enjoy these selfishly in your with your staff and brag that you got a box of Adriana's cookies as well from the town of Winthrop. So there you go. Enjoy.
Well, of course they were Italian cookies.
That's right.
Of course. And since the governor seems to like cupcakes so much, I'm so happy I get the cookies.
You bet.
And does that mean I have to share these?
No, you can keep them.
Okay, these are mine.
And do whatever you like.
Mine. Yes. This is good. Thank you very much.
Yes.
I'm not sure these will make the ride home. But we'll enjoy them for sure. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Very much.
And thank you for coming. So with that, I'd like to introduce Environmental Secretary Matthew Beaton, who's here to make several presentations. Secretary.
Thank you all very much. Thank you, A, for the applause, but more importantly, just for being here. It's a beautiful day now. With the sun looks like it's trying to pop out, and we have a beautiful backdrop for what is a very exciting day as we are here to announce a number of grant programs throughout the Commonwealth for some very important projects that will go a very long way in addressing some very serious issues related to climate change. Before we get into the details, though, I'd just like to, I have the great honor of being able to acknowledge some of my former colleagues and some local officials here, so please bear with me for a moment as I make a few recognitions. First and foremost, I don't see them here. I wanted to just acknowledge a couple of folks from our shop over at EEA. Oh, there's one. Hey, Brad. How you doing? Of the folks over at Coastal Zone Management that do the great work working with you, many of you local officials here. Have communicated with Brad and Bruce Carlisle. Brad Washburn, the assistant director, is here, and Bruce Carlisle do great work over at Coastal Zone Management, working day in and day out to address these issues and work with the local officials, many of whom are here today. So, Brad, on behalf of all of us here today, thank you and all of your staff for all the great work that you do. There are a number of my old friends here from the legislature who it's always great to see. One individual in particular probably needs no introduction to everyone here, but a great man who I will be introducing in a minute to come back up, but Speaker Bob DeLeo, thank you very much for being here. So Senator Anthony Petroselli, another great great friend of the area and a great legislator. Representative Rosalie Vincent. Representative Randy Hunt. Donald, you're not on my list here, but a good friend of mine, Representative Donald Wong. Yep. And you're apparently filling in for Representative James Cantwell, who couldn't be here, but I hear might be trying to get up here. I would also like to take a moment to just acknowledge a few local officials. From the town of Essex, Lisa O'Donnell, Chair of the Board of Selectmen. From Brewster, Charles Sumner, Town Administrator, and Chris Miller, Natural Resources Director. From New Bedford, David Fredette, City Engineer, and Michael Paul, Director of Environmental Stewardship. From Barnstable, Nina Coleman, Sandy Neck Beach Park Manager, and Lynn Poyant, Community Services Director. From Lynn, sorry Bill, Bill Buckneck.
You got it.
All right, project coordinator. The city of Boston, my friend Austin Blackman, Chief of Environment, Energy and Open Space, and Carl Spector, Director of Climate and Environmental Planning. From Winthrop, Jim McKenna, Town Manager, Joe Demolowitz. Demolowitz? Grant and Administrator and Town Planner. From Chelsea, Alexandra Train, Urban Planner, Project Manager, and John DePriest, Director of Planning and Development. And the City of Quincy, Maureen Geary from the Mayor's Office, and Kara Chisholm, City Planner. That is all for the introduction. So now for the fun part. We are here to obviously celebrate two great programs that do a lot of great work. The Lieutenant Governor and I, in our early days in office, were greeted with a wonderful 25 days of nonstop snowfall and intense winter storms. And in that time frame, we actually, on one visit, went down together and visited a couple of the coastal communities that are receiving awards here today. And we saw firsthand the devastating effects of climate change. It's real. And we know in Massachusetts that it is real because we see it with every one of these storms. As our climate changes, we have more intense storms and more higher frequency of these intense storms. And it is becoming very clear to us that we need to address this problem. That is why the Baker-Polito administration is fully committed to doing all in our power to mitigate our impact of our day-to-day lives on climate change, but also to get ready for a changing climate, to recognize that the climate is changing and adapt and become more resilient to this changing climate. There is a lot of work to be done. We have done a lot of great work. The Commonwealth of Massachusetts is really led the way and been a shining star example to the rest of the nation on how to address some of these very complicated, difficult, and quite frankly, expensive situations to address. And that is why programs such as this that we are here to celebrate today are critically important to making sure that we invest in our infrastructure, we plan for the future, and we are making the Commonwealth a more resilient and more adapted state to this changing climate. So with these two programs, the Coastal Community Resilience Program and the Green Infrastructure for Coastal Resilience Grant Program, these are two phenomenal programs that got started just a year ago that we are very proud to be here today to extend our commitment with the new administration to acknowledge the struggles that you deal with on the local level on a daily basis and our state commitment to be partners with you, to provide you the technical assistance and the financial resources to be able to address these very local issues that have a statewide economic and impact felt by all the citizens of the Commonwealth. And as I noted before, we have a couple of other speakers that I am going to yield the microphone to. Something I wasn't very good at it doing when I was at the time in the House. But one gentleman in particular that I never would have hesitated to yield the microphone to is a great friend of mine, a great friend of the administration, and I know a great friend of many of you here today. He is not only our great speaker, but he is a great man and someone I am very proud to be able to call a friend. And that individual is none other than Speaker Robert A. DeLeo.
Thank you so much, Matt, and I can't help but state watching Matt grow up in the legislature before taking on this particular position. When he was appointed, I had called the governor, and I said, you couldn't have appointed a better guy. A young man, again, whose growth that I saw year after day, actually, and to what he's become today, Governor Baker couldn't have made a better appointment in terms of environmental affairs than this young man right here. And the same for the Lieutenant Governor, although she wasn't appointed, she was elected. So it's a little bit different. But she was also a very good friend in the legislature. Once in a while, she would test me a little bit. You know what I'm talking about. But despite that fact, because of her Italian heritage, I made that sort of forgot about it. But she's been wonderful, especially those of you here from various cities and towns. I think you understand what her importance has been to the administration in building a closer relationship with the cities and towns throughout the Commonwealth, no matter how far they may be from the State House. That's what she's all about. And I'd have to say, at our Monday leadership meetings, she's very quick to point out what the cities and towns need. So I want to congratulate you, Madam Lieutenant Governor. Now, I had hoped with my new extra whiskers over here, and I told my staff this week, I said, you know, maybe, just maybe, Janet Wu won't recognize me. Janet Wu was one of the top reporters. And who was it who first person to recognize me but Janet Wu here today? And she said, you're not getting off that easy. You're going to see me after the event. I got some questions for you.
You can run, but you can't hide.
Yeah, from you, I expect you to be at the House or something like that. And especially my colleagues, are here. Representative, I remember the good days when he was a representative. Now he's a senator. Senator Petroselli and Representative Vincent, who I have the wonderful opportunity to share a district with. And you can't think of a better twosome and a group, I think, that we have in representing of our district than I think working with them. I'm a lucky guy. Thank you. Donna Wong, who, by the way, if you're in the area, about a half of hour away with traffic, Kowloon Restaurant is right up on Route 1. I want to throw that. A couple of years ago, Donald came to one of my fundraisers, as a matter of fact. He prepares some food for it, all right? I don't want to get him in any trouble, but he is a friend. And he, when he came to the fundraiser, instead of bringing Chinese food, he brought pizza. That's the type of guy he is. But again, a great guy. And of course, Randy Hunt from down the Cape area. And as I was joking with Randy, I asked him if he wanted to stick around a little bit later and take a look around the town. But he's in the process of going down to Dallas. Is your son or daughter you had down there?
We have two new grandkids.
Two new grandkids. You realize every time I talk to you, that's what you say to me.
I know, we're up to nine now.
Okay. So we've arranged to have just a little ferry service from here to right to the airport, so you won't have to go through any. And one other person I'd like to mention, also a very good friend when he was in the House, who was one of the top folks in my leadership team at the time, as a matter of fact, now serving as one of the secretaries to the governor. I lost the tug of war with the governor on this one. Secretary Kyle O'Basil is here. Thank you. To the local leaders, Jim McKenna and Peter Gill and Joe Demolowitz, thank you so much for having me here, and thank you most importantly for being, you know, such a partner that we've worked together. Sometimes that's not always true in terms of local, state, and federal government, but I can tell you that that just isn't true with us. Thank you for the courtesies that you've extended. We also, I'm also glad to see a former member of the Board of Selectmen who is here. Bob Driscoll is here, by the way. Thank you. And to all of you, no matter what city or town you're from, welcome to the great town of Winthrop. We hope you'll stay for the rest of the weekend. We'd love to welcome you here. We got places for you to stay. We got fine restaurants. We got beauty. Hopefully the weather will change. It usually doesn't rain in Winthrop. This is only the third time since I've been speaker that it has rained in Winthrop. So, but hopefully you can stay. But most importantly, congratulations for your receipt of the awards today. I was a member, former member of the Board of Selectmen here for the town of Winthrop. So I fully realize what it takes to be a local official, whether you're elected, whether you're appointed, or whatever it may be. And the yeoman's work many times in grants such as this, you should be receiving the accolades, which I'm sure you'll be receiving a little bit later on. But most importantly, welcome to our town. And I'd also like to thank the Baker administration as well. I'd have to say, I think that the first 7.5 months or so, I think the start of the Baker administration and the Senate president and the Senate and myself in the House have gotten off to a dynamic start in terms of representing the constituents of the Commonwealth. All that stuff you may read in terms of what's going on in other states, and especially in Washington, in terms of coming, a lot of things coming to a halt because of partisan bickering, that doesn't occur here at the State House. We try to get things done. Most importantly, put all our egos aside and get things done for the most important people that we represent, obviously, our constituents. And I can tell you that I thoroughly enjoyed, you know, working with the governor, and especially his secretaries and administration, the lieutenant governor. They're all great. You've got to bring those cookies, by the way, to Monday. Because I'm going to call them as soon as I get out of here and tell them that. This funny story about Adriana's, by the way. It is one of the governor's spots. He had called me. He said, did you ever hear about this place called Adriana's? And I says, yeah, I says, it's a new place. I haven't been in there. I was there close to when they opened, but otherwise I had not been in there. He says, I got to go over there. He says, I heard it's very good. That's good. I says, what do you want? He says, I'll get it for you. Just tell me what you want. The only thing is you're going to have to pay me. You make more money than I do. He says, no. Winthrop's not that far from Swampscott. He says, I'm going to go. The next thing I know, the very next day, because I was going to surprise him in a couple of days, he comes in with a box, a box full of muffins and all kinds of goodies. And that's why you got that vote that you recently got. A couple of days. I'm just joking about that, please. But with all the introductions now gone, we often talk about the climate change in hypothetical terms. But as we stand here on the town landing, which I think you'll find is just a beautiful spot in our little town, we see here firsthand how these grants can have an immediate impact on our communities. And I know all of you all know that so well. Many of your towns, I think, like Winthrop, grapple with the effects of erosion, changing coastlines, and waterways, and flooding. In my hometown, the grants will help to address these issues. But they will do far more than that, I feel. as I feel they're going to do in your communities as well. These funds will also enable our towns to save money, to improve our infrastructure, and address public health concerns as well. In short, these investments made here today will make Winthrop and cities and towns throughout the Commonwealth a better place to live, to work, and to raise a family for years to come. I know that you share that sentiment, and I am proud to stand with a team of wonderful individuals who continue to find ways to create a better future for our great state. Mr. Secretary, Madam Lieutenant Governor, members of the of your staff, I want to sincerely thank you. Thank you all again. And I look forward to seeing the tremendous benefits that I know will come from this investment in our state. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Always a pleasure to, I miss hearing him talk on a regular basis, so it's always nice to be able to get out and be with him once again. The Speaker really nailed something that has truly made being part of the Baker Polito administration, especially having come from the House, to see the amicable relationship and the immediate willingness to work together from you and your office and the Senate President and down through Lieutenant Governor Polito and the Governor has just been something to watch and made my experience as Secretary that much better. So, thank you very much for your cooperation in that effort. It's trickled down to myself and our staff as well. So thank you very much for that. And another integral piece of that equation is another champion of all things municipal, someone who comes with a municipal background, a time in, as a selectman in her community, and someone who has put her finger on the pulse of 351 cities and towns across the Commonwealth, and has championed many initiatives to assist and be partners with our local communities, and has done that out of an own personal passion and a drive to want to see the best for every single one of our communities. She is a good friend, not only to me personally, but to 351 cities and towns and all of you. And I think by now she's probably been to every one of them. It is a great honor for me to be able to be here today. Before I do that, I just noticed another fine representative that I'd asked to come join us up here. Representative James Cantwell made it. Thank you, Jim. How you doing? And perfect timing for me to introduce to you the Lieutenant Governor of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, Ms. Karen Polito.
It is great to be here this afternoon. Any excuse that we can find to be here in the hometown of the speaker, we find here. And I just want to say to all of our colleagues, thank you for being here. I have been able to visit many of the communities. We have 78 coastal communities in this state, and it's great that you would come here today to recognize the importance of this grant program and to be able to share a little of our resources at the state level to help protect the coastline, which is such a valuable asset to our Commonwealth. People come from all over the world to Massachusetts. Some people come from parts of our country that never see the coast. We get to see it and feel it, and you in particular here in Winthrop, every single day. And sometimes people, forget that and just sort of can't fully appreciate how important our coastline is, not only to our quality of life and to our environment, but to our economy. We have some of our Chamber of Commerce folks here today, but it is so important to our Massachusetts history that we need to protect it, make it even more resilient, and that's exactly why we are here today. But before getting there, I do want to just say some special words about our dear friend, the Speaker. Now, earlier this year, Governor Baker was called upon to do something that he had never done before. And that was to shave his head for charity. He did, and after he did that, it was obviously for a good cause, $250,000 to a very important cause. His poll numbers just went through the roof. So all I can think about as our speaker is growing his hair longer and growing his beard. I'm just thinking if there's a poll done, yours are gonna just be flying right through the roof. So I think it's all working for our speaker. I think he's looking great. He's looking great. So if my poll counts, then you're going right through the roof right there. On a personal note, just a very big thank you to the speaker. You know, we've had some very challenging circumstances that we've come into as a new administration. Certainly, the budget deficits for the current year and the new year, and being able to work with someone with such a steady hand at the head of our House and legislative process was very, very important. And for someone that was able to work with our administration, figure out the right solutions, but then make sure that we were protecting increases to local aid for our cities and towns across our Commonwealth, and school aid and our most vulnerable at the same time, took extraordinary leadership, putting politics aside and getting that job done together. We are enormously grateful for his leadership, and we thank him. Also deserves a very special thanks. The storms that challenged all of us throughout the state this winter were very impactful for a lot of reasons, but it did reveal the need to restructure and reform the operation of the T. That is a system that people rely on right here in this community to get to work, get to their medical appointments, for students to get to school, and we need the MBTA system to work. Part of our economy, it is part of the fabric of our quality of life, and the speaker recognized that. Given his years of experience, not only as the speaker, but in the legislature, really in tune with his constituency, his friends, and his neighbors. And he stepped up early on in the process as a really strong leader on Beacon Hill and challenging the status quo and really pushing for some reforms. We could not have accomplished reform and having the tools to fix the T if it wasn't for Speaker DeLeo, and we are enormously grateful. And then just on the community level, the governor signed his very first executive order for me to be that lead person in contact to our cities and towns across the Commonwealth. He reminds me every day I'm chasing 351 cities and towns. And yes, we have visited many of them, and we have a community compact program that any municipal leader that's in this room, please visit and allow us to work together in a strong partnership. But the program, while it is signed and approved by an executive order, required funding. And I want to say thank you to the speaker again and to my colleagues in the legislature for funding the community compact program, which will continue to encourage best practices, continue to encourage the partnership that we need between the state and local government. And I just want to thank you very much for allowing us that opportunity. We have over 75 communities in the pipeline that have applied for the program. We have 12 that have signed a compact already, and I believe I'll be coming to your community soon to do more of that. As we stand in this building, this is another example of a good partnership with state government. I understand that the Seaport Council funding was available to help in part with this ferry building. I love that Winthrop owns and operates this building. It's going to be a great source of, maybe not profit, but it will be sustained according to your operation model. But what an enhancement to the quality of life and to the economy here. To get to that city in 17 minutes by ferry with a beautiful ride, I mean, that's a pretty nice enhancement to this community. So congratulations on getting that done. The governor has asked me to chair the Seaport Economic Council. So the 78 communities that we're working with through that council, I'm sure we'll be doing a little bit more business, and hopefully more opportunities like this will be available in other places along our coastline. So thank you. Thank you for coming today. Thank you for traveling, some of you a little further than others, to be here. And let's just talk about why funding of these two programs, again, with our partners in the legislature, are so important. As the secretary said, remember now, the secretary hails from the great town of Shrewsbury, which is my hometown. We've got that detail. But we, even though we're not a coastal community, we're very much rooted in central Massachusetts. We know the importance of the coastline. We have a secretary that is, I think, probably visited most of these coastal communities, not just in the winter, but there's a little joke in our administration that which secretary has the most fun in his job? Because you will find him oftentimes in kayaks, you know, with bald eagles that are nesting in trees. I mean, he's all over the place. So today, the Coastal Community Resilience Program is a municipal grant program. Congratulations to all the recipients today. And the Green Infrastructure for Coastal Resilience Grant Program is also available to benefit these communities. We have been able to grant over $5 million in this program already, and today we announced $2.2 million in support of efforts to reduce risks from coastal flooding. Obviously, this winter, I did get a call to come visit Representative Cantwell and others in the Scituate and Marshfield area. And while there, we were able to witness firsthand in a very different day than this, the effects of a coastal effect. And there were seawalls that were very much compromised during that process. But this program and these grants allow communities to think about non-structural ways, natural ways to protect our coastline. If it's a study or to look more innovatively at how to do that, these programs are available to you to do that. And I can see it right here in the awards that we're making today. So rather than me give out each one of these awards, because these are so community-based, I'd like to call upon the legislators to help present these awards to their respective communities. We have the ability to start with Barnstable, so I'm going to call Randy Hunt, who will be able to give the award to Barnstable.
Good to see everybody here today. I'm also joined by my wife, and we're flying down to Dallas. I'm sure I'm going to have to explain to Mary the first 20 minutes of this event because of the firefighters that were changing clothes behind us and distracting her, no doubt. I'd like to bring up Lynn Poyant and Nina Coleman from Barnstable. Nina, as you can see, is an official out there. So if you go to Sandy Neck Beach, you will see her working very hard to make sure that you have a good time during your time out there. The town of Barnstable has been awarded $148,500 to study wind and wave forces affecting the Sandy Neck shoreline and evaluate long-term management options for protecting the public beach facility from storm and flood damages. So congratulations to you for that.
Congratulations, Barnstable, and the next, we're going in alphabetical order, so this doesn't have to be a complete mystery. The great city of Boston, and of course, we want to call upon the great Senator Anthony Petrocelli, too.
Thank you very much, Lieutenant Governor, and thank you for inviting me here today. It's you and Secretary Beaton. That's great to have you back in town. You're no stranger to these parts. I haven't come to Revere very recently. I also wanted to say thank you to the speaker for his very kind remarks. He knows the feelings mutual from all of my colleagues that we enjoy working with Professor DeLeo. I'm being very kind. It's taken 10 years off. I think you look 10 years younger, at least, with the beard, Mr. Speaker.
10 years and rising poll numbers.
See that? What a combination, right? If the folks from the city of Boston want to come up, I'll read through this and present this grant. The city of Boston, in partnership with the Boston Redevelopment Authority and the Green Ribbon Commission, has been awarded $350,000 for the review and development consensus on local climate change projections and impacts, identify vulnerabilities, and develop an initial portfolio of actions to strengthen the resiliency of buildings, neighborhoods, and infrastructure. I also want to say thank you as representing the town of Winthrop for the two grants that are being given out to Winthrop as well. All these grants we know will make long-lasting benefits for the community and the quality of life that we represent here. So thank you, Mr. Secretary, Lieutenant Governor, and the Governor Baker as well. Thank you.
Okay, so to the great town of Brewster, I'd like to call upon Secretary Beaton to present this award.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor. The town of Brewster has been awarded $159,474 to provide information to the public on the vulnerability of infrastructure and natural resources to flooding and erosion, gather input on community priorities, and build consensus on local strategies that will enable the town to respond and adapt to changing climate conditions. Having been down there, as the Lieutenant Governor mentioned, I did go down and see this, and I can vouch that it is this is a great project that'll go a very long way. So, are there folks from Brewster here?
Yes.
Come on up.
So now I'd like to call upon my dear friend, Rosalie Vincent, representative, to present the award to the City of Chelsea.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor, Secretary Beaton, and Speaker DeLeo. I know that Lieutenant Governor said that it would rise, you know, make a rise in your poll numbers, and Senator Petrocelli said it looks, you know, 10 years younger. My biggest question to you would be, how does Vicki feel about this?
My poll numbers are pretty low there. They get nowhere to go but up.
I like it though. Okay, the City of Chelsea has been awarded $90,000 to evaluate the vulnerability of municipal infrastructure to the coastal flooding and sea level rise, and identify local and regional strategies, including building retrofits and natural shoreline stabilization methods to reduce future flood risks. And could the town city managers and so on behalf of Coastal Community Grant Resilience Grant Program, thank you.
All right, I'd like to just call upon those from Essex to come forward. I know Senator McGee wanted to be here today, but he couldn't, but we thank him for his support to these programs. And on his behalf, the town of Essex, working with the National Wildlife Federation, Ipswich River Watershed Association, and the Essex County Greenbelt Association, you have been awarded $62,943 to develop informational packets and risk maps and conduct a regional workshop to expand public awareness of coastal vulnerabilities in the towns of Essex, Salisbury, Newbury, Newburyport, Raleigh, and Ipswich. I wish you all the best with this award. There's a lot to that for sure, and I love that you're collaborating with your regional partners. Congratulations to all of you. Okay, for the City of Lynn, I'd like to call upon Representative Donald Wong to present the award. Thank you.
Thank you very much. First, I would like to thank everyone who's involved in both these programs and for picking all these communities. And on a second note, talking about the speaker, I almost didn't recognize him. And I'm jealous because I can't grow a beard. Now I don't know what's going to happen. Every time we go walking down the hallways of the State House, they say we look like twins. You know, yeah. Of course, he's Arno, and I'm, you know. But now on the serious side, I want to thank the grant for Lynn. The City of Lynn has been awarded $73,000 to assess public infrastructure and natural resources at the risk of flooding and sea level rising. this is to help with the prevention of flood in the future. And thank you very much. Anyone from there?
Okay, so for the South Coast region, we do have an award to New Bedford. If someone is here from New Bedford, please come forward, and I'd like the secretary to present this award.
The city of New Bedford has been awarded $255,000 to evaluate flood-proofing needs for 9 of its most vulnerable sewer pump stations and design and permit the highest priority, least complex improvements to provide uninterrupted service during flood events. Congratulations.
Thank you. So for the town of Plymouth, I'd like to call upon Representative Hunt to present this award. Okay.
Very good. For the town of Plymouth, I have an interesting district in that I have one precinct out of 15 that are in Plymouth. But I take that very seriously, that precinct, and we represent a lot of the coastline down in southeast Massachusetts, certainly. The town of Plymouth is, who's here from Plymouth? To
No one?
Okay. I know that Senator DiMacedo, who represented almost all of the rest of the precincts in Plymouth, who is now senator, had called and expressed his feelings that he wanted to be here, couldn't be here today, and I can tell you that this is a very top priority for Senator DiMacedo and me. I'm in his Senate district and the entire coastline of Cape Cod Bay. As you have seen on the news reports during the wintertime, it was under assault by these storms, and it's a very serious issue there. For the town of Plymouth, it has been awarded $73,350 to complete final designs and permitting activities for adding sand, gravel, and cobble along 900 feet of an eroded barrier beach to reduce damages to public infrastructure and restore natural coastal resources and habitat. And I'm happy to receive this, and we'll pass this along to the other legislative delegation and the local officials from Plymouth.
The next is the city of Quincy, and I know we have some representatives from Quincy here. Please come forward. I do want to express my gratitude to Mayor Koch, who has done a tremendous job representing the city. He's worked very hard with us on the Community Compact Program and will be also a member of the Seaport Economic Council. And although you won't be getting beach volleyball as part of the Olympic spirit, you are receiving this great grant today, and we are very pleased to award $75,000 to the Metropolitan Area Planning Council to complete a coastal flooding and sea level rise vulnerability assessment and implement a community education program to inform and engage community members on coastal impact and adaptation strategies. Congratulations.
Thank you.
As I mentioned earlier, obviously situated Marshfield, we're really in the crosshairs of this storm this winter. And Representative Cantwell is a tireless advocate for resiliency along the coastline to protect the valuable assets there and the property and the residents and many homeowners there. I want to thank you for your advocacy, for your leadership, and please come forward to present to the town of Scituate this award.
Thank you very much.
So, Madam Lieutenant Governor, thank you so very much, Mr. Speaker and Mr. Secretary. By the way, when we heard the discussions about who has the best job as one of your secretaries, by the way, I was with Secretary Pollack the other day, and she said that they all were lamenting the fact Matt, that you were able to do a whole press conference by being in the water. She said that you were swimming at the same time doing a press conference. She said it was one of those 90-degree days, and she said, who has the best job there? We want to say, on behalf of the town of Scituate, we're so proud to be able to receive this grant. One is for all of us who know all of these coastal communities, that when we have these kinds of impacts from major storms, it affects everything in our communities. And in fact, for my two communities, we have about 40% of our tax base, Mr. Speaker, just like Winthrop, within about a mile and a half of seawalls and other infrastructure. So having this kind of coastal resiliency grant is so important, because as we're being told by the Dutch, by the way, who about 80% of their country is below sea level, they say they can't retreat, because if they retreat, they have to go into Germany. So what we're learning is really for us, Mr. Speaker, and I think, by the way, Scituate is just like the little brother to Winthrop, by the way. We always want to have you think of that whenever we come forward. Because if it wasn't for you, Mr. Speaker, whenever we're doing things, when it came to any of the work for seawalls or coastal infrastructure and coastal resiliency, you were the one I went to time and again to make sure that we have funds. This, Madam Lieutenant Governor, is a wonderful, wonderful benefit for the town of Scituate. So the town has been awarded $180,000 to study the effect of waves and the movement of sand and other sediment along the shoreline as a basis for identifying and prioritizing viable shoreline protection strategies. Mr. Secretary, we'd want to have you come down soon, because one of the strategies, we actually have an area that could break once again. If we have a major storm, it would make an island out of a major part of Scituate. And we have a great proposal to try to be able to dredge and take all the dredging material and put it right up on the beach to try to prevent that from happening.
Can I bring my kayak?
Please do. Yes, please do. And Mr. Speaker, being, as I said about being like a younger brother, I want to make sure you come up. We have two presentations. One, we did have, as this was going on, Vicky was calling. So, Mr. I just happened to be coming down from, so we have two things for you.
Okay, so you can see that was Scituate beginning with an S, and the final, we have one more.
Yeah.
Okay, right here. Oh, all right, so before we get to that, we're going to go to Barnstable and Sandwich. We want to thank you very much for being here to present this award. Is there anyone from Barnstable and Sandwich here?
Yeah, we have
so
Nina.
Please do come forward.
Thank you. Nina and Lynn, again.
And
John. Oh, John's going to do that? Okay, great. Good to see you.
He's a resident of the Sandwich. Yeah.
Well, these problems don't stop at town lines. So the regional impact of some of these grants is very important to our towns, no question about that. In the communities of Sandwich and Barnstable, we have or are receiving an award of $157,930 to study the volume, rate, and direction of sand moving along the shoreline from the Cape Cod Canal to the easterly side of Barnstable Harbor. In the district that I represent, the shoreline runs from the Plymouth Bourne town line all the way through Sandy Neck to the very tip of it. So this is the area that's going to be studied here. This data will help inform the design, evaluation, and implementation of regional shoreline management efforts. And for all of the work that you've done to push this forward, and the Secretary, the meetings that we had down there, I really appreciate the fact that we're getting a lot of support on this. And so congratulations to all of those who worked very hard for the receipt of this.
Okay, so our final community is Winthrop, and we're very happy that the speaker can be here to present the award to his community. Now, don't read anything into the fact that Winthrop will be receiving two grants today. They completely competed for these grants, and we're very happy that the speaker will be able to present these awards. So please come forward.
First one, the town of Winthrop has been awarded $317,625 to rehabilitate the existing tide gate at Lewis Lake to control flow and allow tidal exchange between Lewis Lake and Winthrop Harbor, helping to maximize available flood storage in the lake and reduce the extent of flooding. In addition to that, the town of Winthrop has been awarded $75,000 to evaluate natural and non-structural shoreline protection approaches and develop conceptual plans for a preferred alternative that provides the most erosion control and improved wildlife habitat along the Coughlin Park shoreline. Congratulations to all the folks.
And to close out our program today, and personally, on behalf of the Secretary, the Governor, and all of our staff, we appreciate your taking time to be here, and we wish you continued success through this program and others to protect the resources that we have along our coastline. And I'd like to call upon the Council President to offer his final remarks and to close out our program. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Lieutenant Governor. I just want to say what an honor and privilege it is to have been the host today to this wonderful celebration. And we appreciate everybody, although lots of people don't know where Winthrop is. They don't know how to get here. I have a couple of my kids live in Milton, and they say, where is Winthrop? And I have to explain it to them over and over again. But I just wanted to question the rationale of the Lieutenant Governor when she talked about the rising polls of our speaker. When our governor polls rose after he ridded himself of his hair, and now look at our speaker who's added hair, I don't know what that's going to do to your polls, Mr. Speaker. Many years ago, I remember when somebody said to me, you know that little kid down at the ball field, the Little League field, Bobby? And I said, no. They said, well, Bobby's running for selectman. Little Bobby's running for selectman. Well, little Bobby got elected. Don't take offense, but little Bobby is no longer little.
Oh, that's a good start.
He's no longer Bobby, and he's no longer selectman. However, with all due respect, little Bobby has never forgotten his roots. He's never forgotten our community. He's always been very supportive to us, and he certainly has worked as a team. And with all, I still call him Bobby, except when he calls me Mr. President, and then I call him Mr. Speaker. So we appreciate what you've done for us, Bob, as well as Anthony. It's really a pleasure to have you on our team. I would be remiss if I didn't mention our town manager, whose recognition of our most valuable resource, and not only his recognition of what the resource is, but his dedication to the redevelopment of our resource, is very, very much appreciated by our community. I was fortunate enough to have spent my whole life so far right out here, right on this harbor, and I've watched it grow. It's been a pleasure for the last 71 years that I've been able to enjoy this harbor and watch its development, and now its ferry, its ferry terminal building, and so forth and so on. So, Mr. Manager, I wanted to recognize you for that. Thank you to everybody who was responsible for the grants that Winthrop has received, and thank you all for coming to visit our beautiful community today.